Lippman, and welcome to TD Station and the city of St. John for this year's home of the Final 12 NBIAA Senior Basketball Championships. This next contest is for the A Boys Championships between the John Caldwell Knights and the Dalhousie Condors. We would ask all those who are able to please stand. Gentlemen, remove your hats as we prepare to sing our national anthem. And as we prepare to sing the national anthem of our country that is strong and free, please take a minute to reflect and think about the people of Ukraine and how our hope to bring peace back to this country in turmoil. And thank you. And now it's time to meet our teams. First of all, from the visiting Dalhousie Regional High School, the non-starters are Tyler Winchester, Connor Mullally, Hunter LePage, Braden Mallet.
Tremendous day of basketball we got ahead of us. I wanted to be something. I wanted to be a wordsmith with it there, but that's the best I got for you guys. I'm so excited to be joining you. This is going to be a fun day. Just kicking things off here, we've got the boys single A final. Later on, you'll hear me call the women's AAA final at 3:30, the guys AAA final at 6 o'clock, and we got a full fun day of basketball ahead of us as we go through the introductions for both teams. John Caldwell and Dalhousie seeing each other for the first time. This is a very unique situation in this final, fans. Neither these teams have not seen each other all year. In fact, talking with both coaches before the game, they, in rare circumstances, knew any of the teams that they had played against in any of their regionals and semifinals, that sort of thing, to get to this point. They went through a lot of their playoff year blind with the teams that they were playing. They had so many tournaments canceled. So they were just really stuck playing just the people in their area, particularly in the single A, and they just don't know each other. So this is kind of a nerve-wracking. If you're a coach, this is a bit of a nerve-wracking situation for you. You're trying to coach your guys to tendencies and that sort of thing that you don't really know for the other team. So it's going to be really fascinating to see how these coaches adjust. And what's really great about that is you got two really good coaches. For all you people out there in the bigger cities in New Brunswick, the Monctons like me and the Fredertons and the St. Johns, these single A schools have players. They have players and they have coaches. You don't see them a lot because, you know, that's just the nature of how it works. Smaller schools, they don't make it to the bigger cities and play the bigger schools a lot, but they got very, very good players and very, very good coaches. And in this case, for John Caldwell, Michel Beaulieu, and for Dalhousie, Rodney Savoy, these guys have been around the block. They've coached under really good coaches, and it'll be really fascinating to see adjustments that happen as this game goes along. So very, very excited. So some players to look forward to in this game for, and the coaches again, as the coaches were yesterday for me for the boys AA final last night, won by Carlton North in a very impressive performance from the end of the game on a 35-10 run to take that game away from Heartland. We've got lots of explosive and talented players, and these coaches have done a really good job helping me out because I haven't seen the players. So to set the stage, kids, be forgiving with me early. I haven't seen these guys, so it'll be a little bit of maybe number four passes to number three there for a minute while I get used to the names and the faces with the uniform. So forgive me, be forgiving in that area. But also, I made the cardinal error of a play-by-play person. I talked to the coaches extensively. We were having a good time. We were laughing and joking. And I didn't go through the routine of pronouncing the players' names for the coaches so I don't screw them up. So please, people out there, I will do so at halftime. Forgive me in the first half if I get a name wrong, all right? And here we go with the single A final. And the tip controlled by Dalhousie. Kiefer Jerome into the corner. Gio Hernandez gets it back to Jerome. He spins and lays it in. Nice work from Kiefer Jerome. He was the all-star on this team for the Northeast. So he's a guy to watch. And look at that defense to step in there. Caleb Savoie not able to get to the other end and finish. If he's able to get a breakaway, you'll see that young man throw it down. In warm-ups, it wasn't a problem for him. He was putting on a little bit of a show, getting his team into it. Extended little zone defense from Dalhousie. And it's knocked out off of John Caldwell. Caden Breal wasn't able to secure it. Knocked off of his thigh out of bounds. And talking to Coach Michelle Bouillier before the game, he was definitely concerned with the explosive athletes that he was going to have to face on the Condors. Really good defense there from John Caldwell. Rich history of John Caldwell Golden Knights, which we'll get into. I have a deep background source that's given me the history of the school from A to Z, from the time they opened till this year. So we'll have lots of information on them. And Dalhousie as well, the coach, was very generous with his time and helping me out, know his players a little bit in the school. And John Caldwell creates another turnover. And they push back the other way. Coach Bulia calling for them to push. Cody Michaud into the corner. Caleb Bulia and up top. There's a back rim jumper missed by Caden Purley. Rebounded by Dow going the other way. They're going to run. There are those athletes. And finish at the other end by Jaden Mullally. Grade 10 kid, so a couple of real impressive looking grade 10s for Dalhousie. Bright future. But the future is now for these guys, too. Almost forced another turnover. Recovered there by Michaud. Into the corner. Back looking for the big guy inside. He turns around and throws up a baby hook. It does not go for Caden Breal. And it's rebounded by Dal. And we're back the other way. 4-0. 8:13 clock running first quarter. Dalhousie looking to push the pace again. Good hands there from Breal. Pushing that ball out of bounds. Into the game. Early substitution for Dal. Connor Mullally comes in. Looks like Caleb Savoie is a little banged up. Might need some attention. We'll see what the... Looked like he was kind of favoring his shoulder a little bit when he came out. JCS with a double team there in the corner and creates a turnover again. Let's see if they can take advantage. They haven't been able to yet. Force some turnovers from Dow, but they've been turning the ball over themselves. A nice little baseline drive there. But not finished. And rebounded by Dal. That was Isaac Anderson inside. Up top to Jaden Mullally. Drive from Kiefer Jerome. Not quite there. And rebounded by Caleb Bulia. Back comes JCS. Anderson. Stuck on the wing. Needs to get it back out to Michaud. Michaud on the drive, met by two Condors. Off to the corner to Bulia. He drives. Purley now inside with a sidestep. Missing everything, and that's going to be a shot clock violation. Michaud Just missed everything, and 3 minutes in almost. Still that goose egg on the scoreboard for John Caldwell. The saving grace, they picked up their defense a little bit at this end when Dal hasn't been able to get out and run. They've been facing difficulty even getting a shot up. And baseline there. On the drive baseline from Jaden Mullally, got knocked out of bounds by John Caldwell. It's going to stay with Dal, and they call timeout to chat things over. So these teams, it's a very interesting, this is a long drought that's going to be ended by one of these teams. John Caldwell hasn't been to the Aiken Center since they lost to Grand Manan just before the turn of the century. And that sounds like turn of the century. You're being dramatic. Well, hello, it's 2022. It's been a while since the Golden Knights have been to this stage. Lost to Grand Manan the last time they were here, so they're hungry for a championship, and just as much as Dal is. Dal, it's been since Coach Neil Smith, who's now the coach of Moncton High School, going to play in this building later, since he was coaching his son to the TD Station Center here back in around 2007, 2008, somewhere in there. So it's been a long drought for these teams, and both of their coaches real hungry to end the drought. I know, talking to Rodney Savoy, he's been with this team now for 7 years. He followed one son up to the team. Now he's got Caleb here that he's coaching, so he's got a nice little run here with both of his kids. He's had some good teams, but they've never gotten over the hump, and he was some excited for his guys to get this experience, and that's what you hear from these coaches. They don't talk about how much it matters to them. They talk about how much they love the fact that their kids, at the end of this two-year weird stretch of life for everyone, have earned this trip to this stage to put their talent on display for everybody in the province, and they're excited to do it. And look at that step baseline, long loping strides of Savoy. Boy, little Antetokounmpo in those steps baseline for Mr. Savoy, and they create another turnover. 6-0 Dal, stifling defense from the Condors. And Kiefer Jerome finds Savoy on, swings it all the way over. Nice look to Jaden Mullally. He finds his man right back again for three, but it's long. And torn away there in the corner, and on the run is Cody Michaud. Cut off nicely by Kiefer Jerome. Almost trapped in the corner, gets it back out top. Nice spin and motion there. Gets back to Braille, but happy feet. They turn it right back over again. And Dal's just doing a terrific job of speeding up the Golden Knights, making them uncomfortable, making every pass longer than they want it to be. It's getting in their heads a little bit. You start to think about it now once you approach the midway point of the first quarter. You're still not on the board yet, but their defense has been good enough. It's a 6-point lead. Could be a lot worse. Still playing hard on this end of the floor. And Jaden Mullally into the corner. Gio Hernandez back out to Kiefer Jerome. He's a little bit over dribbling there. And good defense again by the Golden Knights. If they get him in a half-court situation, more often than not, they've been stifling them, and this is good news if you're a Golden Knights fan, because they have not been able to get on the board yet. And that's nice movement this time. They get it to a wide open Caleb Bulia for three. Not able to hit, though. And rebounded by Gio Hernandez for Dal, and they're pushing it again. Not there this time. Swings it all the way over to Jerome. Does Mullally. Jerome on the bounce, not there. Tries to get it back to Mullally, but it's taken again nicely. Good defense again by John Caldwell. If they could just get the lid off the basket, but another turnover. Jerome takes it right back. Good communication there by the Golden Knights. Oh, Jerome with a sweet little crossover, but into defense. Hands up and no foul there. Oh, but turned right back over the key for Jerome, and John Caldwell just cannot take care of that ball. Wonderfully defended there. Oh boy, I'm not sure how much more. Not sure how much more Caden Perley could have done there, really, defensively. Looked to me like he cut off the ball handler pretty good there. Took it on the chest, but foul called. And up for three is Kiefer Jerome. It's long and rebounded by Cody Michaud. Michaud pushes, tries to keep stand of a double team. Now he's got to get rid of it. He's picked it up in the wrong spot, but he's able to get rid of it. The ball again turned over, and again it is Kiefer Jerome. He might have five steals already for Jerome. I'm going to have to check the stats here as we go, but he is gobbling up those long passes from Golden Knights. And now he's going baseline, laying it in with the right hand. Kiefer Jerome showing why he's the all-star pick for this team for that section of the Northeast on both ends of the floor. Peyton's now inside, almost another turnover. John Caldwell gets a wide open shot, not able to hit again, just off to the side for Beaulieu. Dalhousie now 8-0 here, looking to run again with those athletes. Well defended. Oh, looked like it might have been a travel, but not called. Up for three now. It was Jerome, and it was long. It's rebounded by JCS. They get a chance to push here, and they get bailed out. Boy, that was another turnover, but got bailed out big time. Whew. Anderson had gotten himself up in the air and had absolutely nowhere to go. That was going to be a turnover, but got bumped by Sebastian Noel. And now, off the schneid are the John Caldwell Golden Knights. A sigh of relief, you can feel it, as Beaulieu knocks it down. The 5'11", grade 12 kid gets his team on the board in his last game for John Caldwell. The ball is swung all the way over to Kiefer Jerome, using the screen. Dances in the lane, little Euro step, tries to finish on the reverse, is not able to. Rebounded by Caden Perley. Beaulieu now getting called for the charge. Dalhousie is absolutely smothering on this end of the floor. The only saving grace for the Golden Knights is they've played him pretty solidly on the defensive end. I'm trying to get a sense here for what the issue is. They've given four to JCS. It should be 2 points for them. Should it be 10-2? Is that what we're doing? Yeah, it should be two for JCS. That's the only two that they've scored. Yeah, they've got the correct score there now, 8-2. All right, so I thought maybe there was another issue maybe with the clock of some sort, but no. Just the score, they were straightening it out. And here comes Kiefer Jerome. Around easy as you like. Boy, that is too easy if you're a Golden Knights fan. Their defense has largely been good, but off the bounce a couple of times, they've been victimized. And now Jerome again gets a turnover and finishes with the right hand. Boy, have yourself a quarter, Kiefer Jerome, on both ends. He's keying the defense. He's scoring the ball, and now the Golden Knights have a chance here. Michaud on the catch, but backs it out. Anderson up top, and that's going to be Cody Michaud for three. And the bank, the TD bank, the TD station is open for Cody Michaud. A big one for them. It's 12-5 here now. 2:13 clock running first quarter. And there he goes, that man again. Not able to finish, though, is Kiefer Jerome. And now, yeah, absolutely. I think it's going to be a warning. Boy, he's lucky he didn't get he didn't get some sort of unsportsmanlike foul there, or T at least. Very lucky. A warning from the referees before he got one. He faced some physical defense when he drove inside, and not the reaction you want to see. A little shoving action from Jerome, but a little chat was had. We'll see how that calms things down. That's going to be a shot clock violation. More good defense from JCS. Boy, if you'd have told them, look, we're going to give up 12 in the first quarter to this athletic Dalhousie team, they would have taken that, I bet. But the lid's been on the hoop so much at this end. Not so much the lid. They can't get a shot up. Everything's a turnover. And there we go again. Caldwell, though, able to control the bounce momentarily. And then Jerome trying to pick off that pass and go the other way, just a little late. But that's a good chance you can take once you get up. You get these a team like this on their heels, get them thinking. That's a chance you take. I haven't gotten a foul yet. I'm going to try to get there and go the other way. Worst case scenario, I commit a foul. I'm not putting anybody on the line. That's a risk you take every time. It works all the way around. But again, the pressure of the Dalhousie defense, and that time Connor Mullally was out there pestering the ball handler. Every pass is 2, 3, 4 feet too long. And not on target. The turnovers, I would shudder to think of the turnover count in the first quarter for them. Oh, inside again goes Jerome. He's getting to the rim every time he wants. Hasn't finished every time, though. Well broken this time by JCS. See what they do with the ball in the half court. Almost picked off again. If they can find that second pass and be accurate with it, the second pass out of that press, they might get somewhere. But nice move inside by Caleb Bulia. Backs his way in, gets hit, and he's going to go to the line. So that first pass out of that trap is being picked off so often. But then the problem is that once that pass is made, as Bulia unfortunately misses the first, once that pass is made, they're panicked. And that second pass isn't accurate either, and longer than it needs to be, or right into hands. So they're just in panic mode a little bit, are the Golden Knights. This break can't come soon enough to kind of calm them down a little bit, I don't think. Wide of the mark that time was Michaud, but rebounded inside, and going to the line for two is Caden Perley. So, boy, I mean, how big would a couple free throws and a stop and a hoop here be at the end of this quarter for Golden Knights? You could turn around. This might be a 2-3-point game, but interrupting that. Hope is a missed free throw there from Caden Perley, but he's got one chance. Another missed free throw, though, and a missed opportunity for the Golden Knights to bring this down. And Gio Hernandez dances baseline, not there. Out to Savoie. Those long strides. Mullally now. Out to Kiefer Jerome, and he's sidestepping into the key, but getting called for a travel. It's a good call. You do that Euro step, you better take off, get off the floor, and finish that shot. Otherwise, you're dragging that foot behind you. That's just what he did. Nicely broken now. Oh, and a good look inside. Really well done from the Golden Knights. It doesn't pay off, but that was really well executed. Didn't wait around for that double team in the corner. Did Bulia made a nice pass. Just wasn't able to finish inside. Michaud. Now the Condors can't pass it too high in the corner for Savoie. He'll get it every time. Hernandez now driving the lane. Met really well there by JCS defensively. Good hustle, but back to Hernandez. Again through hands and for the second time, Dalhousie turns it over. On a shot clock violation, only 2 seconds left now for the Golden Knights. Looks like we're going to go to the first quarter break here with a 12-5 lead, unless March Madness, the magic of March, occurs here with the Golden Knights. We'll see what they got planned up. They definitely got a plan here. They got a play called. Let's skip that a little bit. He's got 2 seconds to get it up, and he does. Just wide right. And, yes, we go to the first quarter break with a 12-5 Condors lead in a defensive struggle here in the TD Station floor. Boy, that was a turnover fest. And if I'm JCS coach Michel Bulia, I'm talking about taking care of the ball. I mean, there's only so much he's been harping on it, I'm sure, the entire first quarter. But, hey, guys, here's what we need to do. Here's the spots we need to get the ball. And if they could attack, if they could get that ball over the, you know, what they're doing is they're playing right into Dalhousie's hands by taking the ball right where Dalhousie wants them to take it. They're putting themselves into spots. They're where the sideline and the half-court line are additional defenders, and they're holding onto the ball too much, and they're dribbling the ball to those spots exactly where Dalhousie wants. You want to go to where Dalhousie doesn't want you to go, and that's the middle of the floor, and that's if you can get the ball there and attack. So we'll see what John Caldwell does to try to counteract that. Maybe look, Caleb Bulia to me has looked like the player who's most in control of his game, who's most least panicked with the ball in his hands. You want to put him in the middle of the floor, try to get the ball to him, and then let him create something from the middle of the floor for you guys. We'll see if that's something that John Caldwell looks at. If you're Dalhousie, you're going, hey guys, we defended our butts off, but we only put 12 up on the scoreboard. We're not finishing. We're turning the ball over too much. So look, this lead should be much bigger than it is. If you're a Condor fan, you're certainly not comfortable. All right, so my trusty stats man has helped me out here. There we go. Look at that. All the good help that I'm getting up here in the booth on the floor. And fans, this is fun. This is a fun atmosphere for these kids, for these coaches. They haven't played in this much. This is a really heartening a send-off that these guys are getting, win or lose today. Of course, you want the banner flying in your gymnasium, but this is really a good send-off for these guys who've faced ridiculous roadblocks in front of them during these 2 years of COVID to even practicing, let alone playing games. So good on them for sticking it out, and nice pass to Bulia. He puts the ball in the corner, gets the ball back out, and he's going to be popped from the top of the key again by Michaud. Doesn't finish, but a rebound comes out to Anthony Lloyd, but turned right back over and going the other way is Connor Mullally. He'll take it all the way with the right hand, but doesn't finish again. Getting away with one is John Caldwell. More opportunities for Dow that have gone wasted, and you got to think, as we get to the third and fourth quarter, we're going to look back at this first quarter, the turnover in the second, going, boy, Dow had a chance to push it out and didn't do it, and it's come back to haunt them. You hope not if you're a Dow fan. Driving baseline there. Oh, boy. See you later, says Kiefer Jerome. Oh, now you see me, now you don't. Spun back as if he was going to kick the ball out and faked out two Golden Knights and laid it in. And he's been the story so far, big time for his squad. Missed three-pointer from the wing there for Mitchell, but nice rebound again by Cody Peetens, and he's going to go baseline. Boy, that's a nice move. Woo, Cohen Peetens lays it in. 14-7 now, Dalhousie. That was a gorgeous baseline move. A nice kick to the corner there for a three. That's bottom splash from the corner from big Caleb Savoy. Nice feed from Kiefer Jerome there. And again, that's the spot. They want you to pick the ball up there, does Dalhousie. They create another turnover, and again laying it in is Kiefer Jerome. And a timeout, John Caldwell. And I bet Coach Bulia is saying, where did I tell you not to dribble and pick it up? I can only imagine that was part of their conversation at the first quarter break. And they just played right back into the Condors' hands, and they've taken advantage, pushing this lead out to 19-7, 8:29 remaining, second quarter. And you can hear from where I'm sitting, Coach Bulia's message to his team here at the first timeout of the second quarter. I think he's getting raw in the throat with the message he's trying to send to his guys here on how to handle this extended defense from Dalhousie. And if you're Dal, you're going, hey, keep it up. Don't let down now. We should have probably a bigger lead than we've got at 12. I'm not saying that out loud if I'm on the Condor bench, but I'm certainly thinking it. So stay hungry and push this lead out where you can. We'll see. Coming out of the huddle, John Caldwell. Here we go. See if the tide turns here. Cody Michaud picks the ball up. Put the ball, yes, into the center. Oh, and just a travel there. Again, even when they break that press, Dow's bearing down on them with more than one guy, and they just seem to have a little panic in them. That time, Cohen Peaton's just a little bit of panic. Only started playing competitive ball this year, says his coach. Boy, doesn't look like it. Well cut off there by JCS, but a little bit late. A little bit late was Caden Purley on that last line of defense. And Kiefer Jerome again creating problems. 12 points already on 6 for 13, shooting three boards for Kiefer. Back in his hands. What's he going to do with it? He's going to go baseline. Hesitation move again. He's so good with that. Misses another lay-in, though. Boy, he's missed a bunch of bunnies, or this could be even worse than it is. As it is, he's dominating the game with the ball in his hands. Getting into that paint at will. And now he's starting to cause some foul issues. And Coach Bulia on the corner here saying, hey, close it up. Close it up. Don't let him squeak through like that. Then you get into situations like that where you get caught tripping him. And going baseline. Cut off is Savoie. Back out to guess who? Jerome. He's looking for some movement. He's going to have to put it up here against the shot clock. That looked late to me, and it is. Another shot clock violation. And that's on Kiefer. He could hear the shot clock. Everybody was telling him he needed to attack that a little bit early. All right, so again, the wrong spot to dribble it to. Over and over again, the same mistakes from John Caldwell. Michaud just dribbled himself into trouble. I know he's got that feeling you can get rid of that pass, but they know where that pass is going, and they know they can get their hands on it. A miss from Kiefer from three-point range, rebounded nicely by Connor Mullally. Handoff now to Savoie, back to Jerome. Ball knocked away, into lane again. Shot fake, spin, up with the shot. Tried to get knocked away there by Savoie, but collected nicely by Michaud. Now he's going to get the ball at the floor, and he does. Pardon me. Bulia now on the catch, and back to Michaud. That's just not going to get there against the tough Dow defense. That's a forced shot. Once you get that ball over half, John Caldwell's got to know. We got 15 seconds here. We don't have to panic and get the first shot we look at. Another turnover, though, and another chance for John Caldwell to get this back a little bit. Almost turned it right back over. Finds its way into the hands of Anthony Lloyd. Into the corner now. A shot up, and it's long from Peaton's. Rebounded by Dow. 19-7, 6-10. Clock running, second quarter here. The boys' single-A final, NBIAA from TD Station. Triple-A finals coming up, girls and boys. Into the lane, drives Savoie. Knocked away there by John Caldwell. A three in the corner, rattles around, and goes through. For big Sebastian Noel, new onto the floor for Dow, and another turnover, almost. Collected, though, by Peaton's. They get the ball to that second level. Wide open three. Just too long for Bulia. Saved, though, nicely by Caden Purley. 4 seconds left, and Purley's going to have to get it up. He does just at the buzzer, and it rims out, gets his own rebound. No foul call. Rebounded nicely by Caleb Savoie. Boy, that one was needed badly for the Golden Knights. They didn't get it, and the pop three at the other end here is long. For Kiefer Jerome. Probably not the shot I want if I'm the Dalhousie coach. Again, kind of stopping in the wrong spot, but didn't get there. The double team, and oh, beating the double team baseline so nicely is Caden Purley, laying it in off the glass. 22-9 now. Golden Knights, a three up top, and that's going to be wide right from Caleb Savoie. Back to John Caldwell. Dalhousie's doing some stuff offensively to try to keep John Caldwell in the game. They just got to take advantage to the Golden Knights. They're missing a lot of bunnies as Dalhousie. A couple of ill-advised threes. You don't need those threes early in the shot clock right now. Oh, boy. And John Caldwell again is going to call another timeout, I think. They are. Still, you could hear the coaches. Guys, we got nobody in the corner. We got, like, it doesn't seem to be. It seems to be like that whatever Dalhousie is doing out of that first pass for John Caldwell, they are not in whatever set their coaches want them to be in. And, yeah, frustration timeout again here. And it's doubly frustrating for John Caldwell if you're a fan because they're playing well enough defensively to stay in this game. If they could put together some consecutive buckets, this would become a game awfully quick because Dalhousie's keeping them in the game with some ill-advised threes. I think that's probably what I'm talking about if I'm Coach Ronnie Savoie. Listen, we don't need to take three-pointers 10 seconds into the shot clock, 8 seconds in, 6 seconds in. You know, once we, if we get into our stuff and don't turn it over, we're getting into that paint at will, and when we get there, we just got to finish. So I'm lip-syncing his timeout. He's probably talking something completely different because he's a better coach than me, but that's what I'm thinking. And John Caldwell, it's all about how do we handle this press right now. That's what this game hinges on. If we can turn this around before the break and solve it and figure it out and make the adjustment we need to make. Okay, and we talked about it before the game. Neither of these teams have seen each other, which is bizarre for this type of scenario. Usually in a season like this, these teams would have seen each other at tournaments plenty. But no, they don't know each other. And they probably didn't know to coach to this press, this extended kind of zone defense of Dal. This is kind of the same defense that Carlton North used last night in the AA final to make their run in the third quarter. And boy, that's a straight line drive. And again, Dalhousie keeping him in it with another missed bunny. Getting to the rim at will is Jerome, just not finishing. Okay, now we'll see if the Golden Knights calm themselves a little bit. They've broken the press. And how about that runner baseline? Oh, that was sweet by Anthony Lloyd, the grade 10 kid, on the baseline. I thought that was a wild shot, but that was in control. Left-handed floater. What do you know, announcer? Pretty stuff from him. Did they force a turnover? Oh, a nice kick save there from Bulya. Got a future as a goalie if basketball doesn't work out. 22-11, 14 seconds on the shot clock. You get the feeling like right here, if they can get a couple stops and break that press a little more consistently, that the Golden Knights could get back in this game. And nicely defended there, just bad luck. Very bad luck there for Golden Knights. They've defended that real well, just the bounce went out of bounds. But Dalhousie Condors, only 8 seconds on the clock to play with here. Shot fake and drive. Well cut off was Jerome, but he set his man up for a wide open three. But long from Hunter LePage. Rebounded by Caldwell, and they beat the press easy, and they got an easy one at the rim, and they make it. Boy, that's what you want to see if you're a John Caldwell Knights fan. Break the press. Bulya with a sweet feed inside to Caden Breal, and he lays it in, and it's an 8-9-point deficit now, inside 10 for the first time in a while. And another turnover by Dalhousie. And a little energy here from the John Caldwell fans behind me. And subs come back in. Caleb Savoie back in for Jaden Mullally off that turnover. He's a little frustrated with himself. I think he thought his teammate was going to make a different cut than he did. And they look to have they've solved something. They've unlocked something. Have the Golden Knights an absolute replay of the previous lay-in by Mayle off the feed from Bulya, the same two-pass entry to beat the press, and the same dropping of a dime. And now can they defend? And they can again. Off the miss from Savoie, rebounded by Breal, and only a 7-point lead. And again inside, there's that weakness, just can't finish. But that's okay, you clap your hands if you're the Golden Knights coach. That's okay, don't worry about it. Finish the next one. We're breaking that press with ease now. Into the corner for another three there. He made the first one. Did Noel, but he missed the second, but rebounded back to Noel, and he's going to go inside for two free throws. 22-15, Dalhousie Condors. And now if you're a Dal fan, you're a little bit worried. Like, man, we were outplaying them by such a wide margin for much of this first half. Probably should have a bigger lead. Missed a lot of bunnies. Some bad turnovers, kept them in it. And Sebastian Noel puts in the first free throw, pushes the lead back to 8. But if you're John Caldwell, you can get this lead to 5 or even less, or even if you're just keeping it in single digits after the start that you had. You're probably going to consider that a win, but this is a big last minute, 2 minutes and 20 seconds of this half. Huge. That inside one isn't there this time, but man, the second difficult shot from Anthony Lloyd. Hard shot taker, hard shot maker, Mr. Lloyd. That's the second one that I wouldn't have made, that's for sure. Pretty kiss. Back to 7. Oh, nice move inside from Dalhousie, but another missed bunny. Boy, they've missed so many layups. Has Dalhousie so many chances. Smart play from Bullion not to rush that. At half court, they find Braille. Oh, and I think he saw Anthony Lloyd baseline, but a bad pass. Inside. Oh, look at that move into the left hand. Oh, boy. Caleb Savoie. Yeah, grade 10. I had that move in grade 10. Absolutely. Spin move, dance to my left in the lane. Lefty hook. Everybody's got that in grade 10. And swung all the way to the corner. Lloyd's going to try his luck from 3, but it's short. Rebounded back to Braille. Gets his footing, but misses a little fadeaway. And back to Dalhousie Regional High School. Boy, that was a golden opportunity for the Golden Knights to get 2 points closer. Now, all of a sudden, the Condors can push this lead back to double digits. Another hesitation move inside. Boy, that's smooth from Kiefer Jerome. He's got that little hesitation move. Almost got that Kyle Anderson slow-mo from the NBA kind of steps where you think it's not deliberate, not fast, but he gets to where he wants to go. Burrell on the kickout. Finds its way to Lloyd for 3. He's long, but rebounded nicely by Caleb Bullion, and he's going to try his luck at 3. And the bank is open again. TD Bank and TD Station. Twice in this half for Bullion, and it brings it back to an 8-point game. Ball in the hands of Kiefer Jerome. He uses the screen from Noel. Gets it to the corner to Savoie. Turns his back. Fake handoff, and he's going to get in the lane with the right hand. And he gets smacked, but he traveled first. Right back to John Caldwell. So those long loping strides of Savoie. A little long, a little too loping in that scenario. Now with 8.4 seconds left, John Caldwell down 8. Extension now. He's asking Hunter LePage get way up and extend. He wants this defense really, really extended to make this last shot a difficult one. They're going to get one at the rim, though, and going to the foul line. Absolutely, going to the foul line is going to be Caden Purley. And Coach Savoie, Sebastian Noel really felt like he was established, but referees felt he was there a little bit late. How about this if you're a John Caldwell fan? Oh, back rims it. All right, you can still pull it to 7 here, which I think 15 minutes ago, John Caldwell fans, you would have taken it. Looks like they're going to be down by 8 going to half. So 8-point game, Dalhousie Regional High School Condors over the John Caldwell Golden Knights. And the story of that half was the extended press of Dalhousie causing endless problems for John Caldwell and endless attempts at adjustments by John Caldwell coach Michelle Bouillet, and they unlock something towards the end of that half, fans. This is an 8-point game. Dalhousie, you got to feel like you should be up by a lot more. So this is going to be a very interesting second half, fans. 8-point game, Dalhousie Regional 28, John Caldwell Golden Knights 20. We'll see you back here in 9.5.
Thank you.
And welcome back, fans, for the start of the second half of Game 1 of Day 2 of the NBIAA Final 12 here from TD Station in St. John. It's the Dalhousie Condors running a backdoor play out of halftime, looking for two. Not there, and they turn the ball over, knocked away out of the hands of Caleb Savoy. And John Caldwell getting up a three early in the second half. His feet were set. He was confident. It was Cody Michaud. Oh, boy. This lead now is five. And Caldwell is energized. And now it is Dalhousie having a trouble getting into their offense. But guess who? Kiefer Jerome. And he's so... And I don't like the call, and neither does John Caldwell, Coach Michelle Bouillon. I'm not sure what else they can expect defensively. It's not an offensive foul either. It's a no call. Kiefer Jerome is being aggressive, sticking his nose in, trying to create havoc. But when you're dribbling into two guys and they play you well, I mean, it should be a no call. But he earned himself two shots. He took a shot to the face. And now his replacement, Connor Mullally, has to be his replacement at the free throw line. He makes the first. So it'll be interesting to see what happens here with Mr. Jerome. He's the pure scorer and an all-star and the engine that makes the team go. Caldwell secures the rebound off the miss from Connor Mullally. One for two at the line. Now another three up from the corner. Oh, boy. Get out your umbrellas, fans. It's starting to rain. Outside the building and inside. Jumpers. That one was Caleb Bouillon. The lead's back to three now. Putting the ball on the floor. Savoy. Now Hernandez into the lane. And that's going to be a travel. And it's a good call. And early quick timeout from Coach Rodney Savoy. Absolutely. Let's talk about it, says Savoy, and that John Caldwell bench is up and psyched. Back to a three-point game. And like Coach Michelle Bouillon said at the start of this game, he's got players that step up and play, and both squads said this. He's got guys that step up and play when things are at their most important. And John Caldwell's coach, he felt especially strong about that. These guys step up and play when it's most important. And they could have easily, this game could have been out of reach early. Dalhousie came out like a house on fire, defensively creating havoc, creating turnovers, getting layup opportunities. But you turned around and suddenly, most of the way through the first quarter, it was only 12-5 because they weren't finishing a lot of those break opportunities. They were missing bunnies. They were turning the ball back over. And John Caldwell has just stuck with it. And Coach Bouillon has called timeouts, trying to calm his guys down. Here's the way to break their pressure. Here's the way to handle. Here's the passes you need to make. And slowly but surely, this squad has come back. And you got to admire the toughness. Now, if you're Dal, now's your chance to show, okay, we got some toughness in us. We got up early. We've been punched back in the mouth. Can we do the counter punching and step up? And the defense is not quite as extended. Still looking to force to double team them and force turnovers, which they just did. Just not quite as extended. But they didn't quite create that turnover. The ball is back with John Caldwell. And the coach is trying to adjust on the fly to what these teams are doing, telling guys to get to specific spots, and they're not quite getting there because they don't understand. It's tough to communicate in this big gym when you're seeing stuff on the fly as coaches because you haven't played these teams before, trying to communicate, hey, you take a step there, you take a step there, no, come here, higher, and it's pretty comical, and It's tough for these guys, but it's interesting for sure as an observer this close to the floor. Now that ball is going to go back on a missed three from the corner Ball's going to go back to Dalhousie Condors. 29-26. It's Caleb Savoie bringing the ball up the floor. We'll see how long All-Star Kiefer Jerome is kept on the sidelines. Oh, he went up to the intention to dunk that. Didn't finish on the second chance either. And now, we got a tie score in the TD Station. Single A boys final. Banging through another one. Caleb Bouya, the senior, stepping up big for his team, tying the score at 29. And the Golden Knights are golden here so far in the second half. Dalhousie now without their best player. Savoie dances into the lane. Can't finish. Rebounded there by Caden Brayall. Back come the Golden Knights. And they have solved whatever pressure they were facing. Oh boy. Is he on fire? Oh man. That would have been a big finish for Micho. Pardon me, Bouya. Micho with the ball now. Turns it back over. Good steal there from Jaden Mullally. Good hands. And he's going to try to go coast to coast and create one. And he does. Kind of threw his body into there. But no, that was a good play. I know he's saying straight up, Caden Pearley, but he was backtracking. He didn't stay still and take that contact in the chest. He was given ground. So good call from the referee on that one. The John Caldwell fans, pardon, do not agree with me. It is clear, crystal clear, but the unblemished record of referees never overturning their calls, despite complaints from the fans, continues since the invention of the game. Missed free throw there from Jaden Mullally. He's got a second chance to put his team back up on top. He does not. Rebounded nicely by Brayall. Micho pushes it. Move it twice. Moving the ball with much more confidence are these Golden Knights. Oh, followed his shot there. Did Micho out to the corner? Is he going to hit another? No, it's long. 29-29 the score. 6:30 clock running. Third quarter. Single A championship. A tight one here at TD Center. That's a tough one if you're Connor Mullally. Spinning into the lane and then expecting to throw it right back out on a line. And knocked away there by Anthony Lloyd. The youngster had a couple of great moments in the first half. To Mr. Lloyd. And a Mullally and swung all the way back around to Savoie. He's going to be the focal point of the offense at this point for the Condors, with Kiefer Jerome still on the sideline trying to find out what his status is. I want to look inside there for Brayall, and he was not ready to catch it with both hands. Other way goes Jaden Mullally off the turnover, and he's going to have two more shots for that push. Foul on Cody Micho. We'll see. Check the foul trouble, fans. Haven't done that in a while. Caden Pearley for Golden Knights has four. That's a big problem for John Caldwell. Didn't pick up on that. He must have gotten a couple of quick ones there. And another missed free throw. More chances gone wanting for the Condors. And you worry if you're a Condors fan. All these chances, all these layups, all these free throws. Are we going to look back and say, gosh, we could have put this game away early against these pesky Golden Knights? But they do take the lead back on that second free throw. 30-29. Into the corner, Lloyd looking inside to his big man. That had no chance to get there through the long arms of Caleb Savoie. Now turnovers leaking back in to the offense of the Golden Knights. A nice backdoor cut and another missed bunny. Beautiful feed from Savoie to Mullally. Gone wanting again. More chances gone wanting. Now three from the corner. Short for Lloyd. Could have followed his shot there, but didn't. Now pushing the pace is Connor Mullally into the lane. Gio Hernandez, good hustle, keeping it alive. And that's going to be a travel, and it is. Just careless footwork for Mullally, and he's frustrated, and his coach has got to have a chat with the youngster. Grade 10 kid. Sometimes you have these problems with frustration and with the hanging of the head, the body language. Got to keep him engaged, especially still Kiefer Jerome on the sidelines. These guys are going to maybe need to play more minutes than their normal or have more responsibilities than normal. In and out. An attempted three there, but kept alive nicely. And a big block from Caleb Savoie. Braille kept it alive and then collected it for a shot attempt. And Savoie said, absolutely not. But then he turned it over. And back come the Golden Knights, pushing it. Nice 1-2 pass. But that three-pointer blocked nicely that time by Jaden Mullally. Got his hand on that one, not hanging his head there. And Savoie's going to go on the attack, and he's going to go to the line for two on the hit from Braille. So Dal now gotten the lead back. Now they can try to push it out a little bit further here. Just over halfway through the third quarter. To the line goes Savoie. Called an all-around player. Played last summer on the U15 Canada Games prep circuit for Team MB. Was an all-star for the Northeast. And he's dunked in game. So fans, prepare yourself. Gonna get a little treat here. A rare single A school championship final dunk in TD Station. I'm rooting for it. And he, look at that play by Hernandez, cutting off that pass and laying it in. And his coach was hesitant to celebrate until he saw the layup go in from Gio Hernandez, because they've missed so many buddies. With the lead now four, and another turnover. So again now, John Caldwell having a tough time against the energy. Not as extended as it was early, creating all those turnovers, but still energy and length and size here for the Condors bothering John Caldwell. Spinning inside, trying to finish, was Connor Mullally. Not able to, though. Cody Michaud off now to Bulia into the corner. They get the ball inside nicely to Caden Braille, and he hits the turnaround. Lead back to two. Into the corner now. Mullally back up top to Savoie. Savoie trying to be Braille. Braille moving his feet nicely, making it tough on him, but he does get all the way around. But Braille did a nice job cutting off that angle, making him try to finish with the left hand on the other side. Good movement of his feet by Braille. Oh, and a pretty move there from Cody Michaud, rimmed out, but guess who? Braille showing some stuff here in the third quarter for his team, tying the score back up. The grade 10, 6'6", grade 10 kid. Disruptive again on the defensive end and collects the rebound. Gets it back to Cody Michaud. And he's going to use Anderson, grade 9 starter at guard here for this Golden Knights team. That's rare. Look at that three. Splash from the top of the key from Cody Michaud, giving his team a three-point lead. And a 7-0 run here, quick as you like, by the Golden Knights. Hernandez now dancing into the lane. Left hand bothered by Braille again, and collects a rebound. The youngster doing a terrific job, and now a smart foul by Jaden Mullally, the grade 10, recognizing that Gio Hernandez had gone down. And boy, he's having a tough time putting weight on that foot. I don't know if anybody realizes it yet. Oh, he kind of twisted. He's got that wrap on his knee. Maybe just twisted it a little bit and stiffened up on him. Seemed like he's able to walk it off, though. Looks like he'll be okay. They're going to bring him around and check anyway. Probably when you got something bothering you, you get kicked in it or you step wrong, it can just stiffen up on your crack or something, feel funny for a minute, you walk it off, you're okay. It looks like G. Hernandez is going to be okay, Dalhousie fan, so cross your fingers on that one. Caldwell now suddenly finds themselves in the lead by 3 points. A big comeback here, a huge turnaround from how things were going in the first quarter. Credit, full credit to this squad. Only got 3 graduating seniors does this team. So while the future is now, the future is bright for this team. But these grade 12 seniors want to end their careers in a dynamite fashion, and they have put themselves in a position now with a terrific last couple of quarters And Dalhousie now finds themselves in a deficit, but here he is back on the floor. Kiefer Jerome, he's going to pop a three, almost banks it in. Rebounded nicely there, one-handed by Caleb Bulya, fending off a rebounder. Nicely done by Bulya, who's been really good in this half. He's got another wide-open three. Is he going to make it? No, back rims it. Not able to follow his shot. Rebounded well there by Connor Mullally. Nice box out. So Dalhousie now with a chance to come closer. Blocked by Caden Braille. And what a presence the big kid's been in this third quarter. Boy, he gets some grief from his teammates about not being able to dunk yet at 6'6". Sometimes you're that tall, that young. Takes you a bit to get coordinated with your size. But his coach says he's come a long way in that area, and you can tell he's got that coordination to bother shots. Made a couple of shots. Look at that dump off nicely done by Kiefer Jerome. He's really patient, is Jerome. He gets the ball. He's cut off. He's got a lot of little shake and shimmy moves, pivots, shot fakes, ball fakes. And he set his man up nicely there for a finish. And John Caldwell, good drive there. Looked like lots of contact, but no call. Savoie pushes it up. Hunter LePage. Back to Connor Mullally. Back to Jerome. I wonder if he'll look to penetrate. Slow-mo. He doesn't, but a nice pass up top. LePage doesn't want it. We'll see if Savoie can go up against more good defense from Caden Braille, forcing a turnover. Ooh, that break might have been there maybe for the Condors. They didn't take advantage, and there's another three. Short, but good fight there from Braille on that three that was short. Was able to get Caleb Savoie to knock that ball out of bounds. Pardon me, I think it was Jaden Mullally that it was off out of. So 14 and a half seconds left. John Caldwell with a one-point lead. Shot clock off. They can take the last one if they want. Inside to Braille. He turns. Nice look. Cross-court feed. Pretty one dribble up. Braille at the buzzer. Is he going to make it? Yes, he is. And he finishes off a dynamite quarter for the John Caldwell big man. And his teammates are out to greet him. Stone-faced is the young fella. But smile, my friend. You had a terrific third quarter. And the John Caldwell Golden Knights, unexpectedly from the depths, they come back. They've grabbed a three-point lead here as we go to what promises to be an electric fourth quarter. So we'll spend this time. These coaches did such a good job talking about their players and giving me some info on them. We'll talk a little bit about these guys that have been key players in this game. So Cody Michaud for John Caldwell, a grade 11, and could be an all-star on his side of the bracket. His coach thinks he's going to be one next year, that's for sure, for John Caldwell. Caden Perley, we've talked a lot about him tonight, but we haven't given a lot of the stuff, just what his coach says about him. I was just going to say, just what his coach says. Most of his work doesn't score on the score sheet. He's called his best defender by his coach, and he'll never hesitate to take a charge. He has a twin, but they have apparently two different personalities. And they've been playing on the same team since grade 11. He made the NBIA All-Star team this season as well, did Caden Perley. Isaac Anderson, we haven't talked much about him. He's the starting guard, and he's a grade 9, and he's a starter because of his defense. And you can tell John Caldwell collectively plays great defense. Caleb Bulya, we've seen his shooting here in the third quarter, and one of the grade 12s made the All-Star team this year, has been playing on the team since he was grade 8, and his coach has been coaching him since pre-K because it's his dad, Mr. Bulya. And it's not always easy coaching your son, and he knows it. He probably would have preferred another coach some days, says his coach. But they've mostly enjoyed success together. And, of course, Caden Braille, the other grade 10 we've talked a lot about. And he's had himself a quarter to Mr. Braille. He gets teased a little bit from his friends with the lack of dunking ability. I would dare say the young man will be dunking next year. He looks like his coordination's coming together nicely. I mean, he dominated the end of that third quarter. And we'll get to some Dalhousie kids at our next break opportunity, Dal fans. I want to talk about your kids as well, because his coach spoke in glowing terms And I'll need to get to some of the background information on JCS in the fourth quarter here too. Otherwise, all those information that I got from my sources will have gone to waste. So Dow, nice physical there on that possession with Braille down low. Pushed him out of his spot and got a turnover. And back comes the all-star for the Dalhousie Condors. That's Kiefer Jerome, but he misses inside again. Boy, he's gotten into the lane at will. Talented kid. Just hasn't quite had the finish today that I suspect he normally does. Oh, and a nice steal there by Savoy, intercepting that pass. He's going to try to go coast to coast, gets hit, and he's going to go to the line for two. Nicely done by Savoy. Get that big, those big Giannis Antetokounmpo steps going into the lane. Long and lanky, tough to challenge his shot without getting arms or legs. He's got a lot of them. So Savoy, we mentioned, played in the U15 Canada Games prep team and was an all-star in the Northeast. You'll see him on a lot of New Brunswick teams, I suspect, coming up here the next three summers. He knocks it in, 38-37. John Caldwell Knights lead it over the Dalhousie Condors, 9:15. Clock running fourth quarter in your single-A boys championship game. Dalhousie getting that ball trapped in the corner, and that's what they want. They want you to swing that ball around so Caleb Savoy can throw it down to hands. Caleb hates rims. And the TD Station, the trip to the single-A boys final, throwing it down to hands. Energizing his bench. But that's a big one coming back the other way. Caleb Bulya silences the crowd again. That corner three, and he's come alive in the second half. Back to Savoy. Can't beat Braille. Nicely contained by Braille with that movement of his feet. And a spinning lay-in. That's the tough. He's missed a bunch of bunnies. That's one of the toughest ones he's taken all day off that spin by Jerome. He knocks it in, and we're tied again. Ooh, this is fun, fans. Are we going to have another barn burner like we had in the girls' games yesterday? Another three popped up. Oh, boy. He's had a few of those opportunities as Anthony Lloyd from the corner. That one looked pure, but it was just in and out. Tie game. And here on the pull-up is Jerome. And rebounded by Braille. Nothing doing there for Jerome. He's now 8 for 25 on the afternoon. Not as efficient as he would normally be. As we talked about, missed some bunnies. Lots of missed opportunities for Dow to make this, to push the lead out when they had it. Now they find themselves in a tight one. Another pop three that's long, and that's going to be a shot clock violation on John Caldwell. And the energized Condor bench up supporting their guys since that dunk by their teammate. It's odd how a teammate dunking the ball at this level can bring some energy to a bench. There's that, goes that man again. He's looking to beat Braille, but he just can't. But that's a wide open three on the wing from Hunter LePage. Been quiet most of the afternoon, but whew, that was a loud three to put his team up by three. Now he's bothering up top here. Cody Michaud gets rid of it to Peetons. Back to, and now all the way to the corner. He's going to try another one. Again in and out, but rebounded nicely in there by Bulya, and a huge block from Savoy, who's been the star of this quarter so far. Back to the corner again, blocked in the corner this time. Felt he was hit, was Caleb Bulya. Going down the floor all the way on the right hand and rejected in there by Lloyd. Was Jada Mullally, the Dalhousie fans, crazy for a foul, but no, wonderfully blocked as we go to a timeout here for Dal, up three. Their ball. Whoo, a breakneck pace here to our fourth quarter of the single-A boys final. They started slow to these guys, but they have picked it up. Once they got a feel for how each other played, good basketball players kind of have this tendency. Defense was ruling the roost in the first half, but these fundamentally strong and talented kids have kind of gotten their footing here And the ball's looking a lot prettier here in the second quarter. JCS dominated that third quarter, but Dalhousie's pushed back and showing some toughness here on their bench. And they've gone back up by three. So talk a little bit about their kids. We talked a lot about Kiefer. We've talked a lot about Caleb Savoy, Jaden Mullally. One of these great tens, and there's a few of them, talented ones for the Condors. Called a slasher that gets to the rim by his coach and defends real well, and we've seen that. Yes, absolutely, out of young Mr. Mullally. Gio Hernandez, he's one of the seniors. He's called the defensive Tasmanian devil by his teammates. He's still over there on the sidelines. We'll see if he gets back in, whether he's a little bit too banged up. Oh, and a turnover there in the corner. Look at that steal from Cody Michaud. He just wanted that ball more than Dalhousie did. And a nice hands there from Kiefer Jerome, knocking it away. From John Caldwell, trying to go baseline there. It was Cohen Petens. No can do from Kiefer Jerome. Good hands. Cody Michaud now. Over to Lloyd, and just a tough pass, too high for Caleb Bouya, turned over. Back into the game is going to be Isaac Anderson for grade 10 kid. I was going to say fellow grade 10. You forget this kid's in grade 9. Great future ahead of him with this John Caldwell squad, Isaac Anderson. Kiefer Jerome with the handoff to Savoy. Another handoff to Connor Mullally. Back up to Jaden Mullally. He drives baseline left. That's a pick it up. Nice cut. And under the eraser comes over. Caden Braille says no to Kiefer Jerome. Oh boy, the Windex man on the glass keeping it clean. And also the eraser down there right now for Braille. Boy, he's played well in the second half as the big kid. Grade 10, 6'6", bright future for these Golden Knights. But they want their future to be now as well, but they face a three-point deficit. Kiefer Jerome now being real patient, asking his guys to cut. Nothing there, so he shoots a fadeaway. Rebounded by Cody Michaud, and they're going to call a foul on, looks like on Anderson. No, 10 White, excuse me. They called Hunter LePage for the push. The fight down there by the grade 9 kid, Isaac Anderson. I thought he was the one that got called for the foul originally, but no. He was boxing out, got pushed. And back to the action. Three-point game, pardon me, fans. 44-41. Clock running, fourth quarter, 5:18. Another turnover. This time, Hunter LePage there to pick up that bad long lead pass, and he tries to go in and finish. Can't. Savoy on the rebound, though. Pump fake once, twice, and he's going to the line for two. That time, Caden Braille not able to block the shot. Braille, that's only going to be his second. So Braille now with a double-double in this game. 10 points, 10 boards for him. Anthony Lloyd comes back in for Isaac Anderson. Seems to be limping a little bit on that foot. Or maybe that's the strut of a grade 9 kid who's made the senior team and playing at the Teton Station in grade 9. I'm not sure. It might just be a strut. Made the first, did Savoy. Makes the second. Two biggies for the Condors. Pushes the lead back to 5. First time they've had a lead this big in a while. See how the reaction comes from these John Caldwell Golden Knights. First time in this game, in this century for this team. Worked all the way around. Mistimed that rebound. It's time to Jaden Mullally. Now Braille knocks it down from the perimeter, showing everything. The young kid in the second half. Been huge for his team. Brings the lead back to 3. Looking for a handoff or a screen is Jerome, but he's going to pop a 3 instead, and it's long. Got to move the ball a little bit more than that. You're thinking if you're a Condors fan. When you do, you get pretty much whatever you want. Block three-pointer. Oh, Braille came in trying to keep it alive, wasn't able to. Boy, Lloyd really, he really telegraphed that three. And steps on Jerome. His mind was moving faster than his feet, pardon me, were moving faster than his mind. Turnover back to JCS. 4:10 clock running, fourth quarter, three-point game in the single-A final at TD Station. Everything on the line for these teams. Two droughts, championship droughts for these schools. One of them's going to end. Which one's it going to be? Nicely. Oh, I thought that was going to be a foul. Looked like Connor Mullally had it clean and was there was a reach in, but it worked out anyway for Dalhousie as they have the arrow, but they do lose the arrow here for the last 3 minutes and 55 seconds, and sometimes that is a key factor in a late possession. Handoff. Savoy crosses over into the key, gets his man up in the air, and finishes nicely off the glass for two. 48-43, Condors. A little kiss off the glass from Savoy. Oh, the Condors have that 5-point lead back. Oh, and Braille fighting for those rebounds. You wonder if you're a John Caldwell fan, if you've fallen a little three-point happy. It's been the bulk of their shots the last 5 minutes or so. Savoy into the lane is Mullally. He pops a two. It's not there. Rebounded by Anthony Lloyd. Up to, oh, Byrne baseline goes Pearly, but long on the shot. And rebounded by Mullally on the other side, Jaden Mullally. Kiefer Jerome slowly pulls it back out. Calling for a screen or a handoff. Which one's it going to be? Oh, and he goes back door. He suckered him, but he was not able to finish through hands with Savoy. I like that play. Oh, and a big three from the corner. Not able to finish again is Lloyd. That ball not out of bounds? Certainly looked so. I gave up on the play. Wild. Okay, I was looking down at the other end, and all of a sudden the shots were still going up for John Caldwell. Looked to me like it was out of bounds, but... And my goodness. That's a tough call on Mullally there. Going to be a timeout here as we go to the timeout. I'm still trying to figure out where the foul on that was. I didn't see it, but okay. Okay. All right, set the stage, fans. 2:16 remaining, 5-point Dalhousie lead. And his coach gave me, like I say, a lot of... We'll talk a little bit about some of these guys that I haven't talked much about. Hunter LePage called a streaky three-point shooter by his coach. You're not kidding, coach. He hadn't said his main much all game, and he stepped up a couple minutes ago and just drained a big three. Barely said his name, but you know you got a dependable bench guy when he's silent most of the game. He steps up, bangs in a three for you when you need it. Looking at the stats on him, on Hunter, yeah, his third shot of the game was his biggest. He's only taken three. That three was a huge one, though. Grade 11 kid. He'll be back next year. Connor Mullally. We talk a lot about the Mullallys. And Connor, he's a utility six-man called by his coach, where he just plays wherever he needs and plugs him in, fills whatever role that is asked of him. And you've seen him tonight. He's gotten a little bit frustrated at times, a little happy with his feet, had some turnovers, but he's stuck with it. And he's been big in this run here for Dalhousie to seize the lead back for sure. And I got to give a shout out to Sebastian Knoll. He made some big plays in the first half, called the wall by his team. Strongest guy, real popular player with his teammates. Coach loves him, and he's got the nickname The Wall, so I love him. Oh, and he had a shot at the rim, did Caden Braille. That was big. That one he's going to dunk next year, guaranteed. Comes up short, though. 5-point lead, under 2 minutes now. Clock running, fourth quarter. They're extending the defense a little bit, trying to rush these Condors. Create some turnovers maybe, and they've got him stuck in the corner, and they did get the turnover they want. And his coach is yelling push. They need They need some points on the scoreboard. Oh, Brea was open, but about 3 seconds too late was Micho on the pass, turned it over. And that was designed, pardon me, fans, I needed a long swig of water to get ready for these last minute and 33 seconds. But they're extending that defense out. Caden Braille with his two fouls, his length, they want him out there bothering, face guarding Kiefer Jerome. At least they were on that inbounds anyway. Oh, nicely cut off baseline. That's a good call. A very good call from the referee on the corner. He tried to force a baseline, was met perfectly there by Caden Purley. Extremely well done. Now these breath of life still for John Caldwell. 1:16, clock running fourth quarter. They need a good possession here. Lloyd now. Oh, and it finds it just to the right guy at the right time, but it rims out for Caleb Bulya in the corner. Just what they wanted. They wanted a trap there. They didn't get it. They didn't get the turnover either. Oh, almost had one there. To the corner to LePage. LePage back up to Kiefer Jerome. He's found his way into the floater. He misses though, rebounded by Caleb Bulya. Still breathing are these Golden Knights. They need something to happen on this possession. Caleb Bulya spinning. He's going to try to go baseline. He does. Leaves it nicely. Oh, just not able to finish. Inside and now foul. That was a missed shot there by Cody Micho. Well set up. Well set up by Caleb Bulya. Just was not able to finish. 27.2 on the clock now. 5-point game. They're going to go all out for a steal here. You're going to see maybe if Dowsey goes long. Oh, they had him too. But instead, they pass the safe one in the backcourt. Jaden Mullally is fouled. That is five fouls, and they're going to be shooting free throws. So now, Dalhousie Condors. First time in this game in a dozen years, roughly, we're guessing here. Oh, actually probably more than that. Maybe close to 15 years since they've been in this situation. Their fans are hungry for a championship, and they can salt this away at the line. All they've got to do is make free throws. It's been a struggle this game so far. This isn't a given. And it rims out. Nice release by Jaden Mullally. That wasn't a choke miss free throw by any means. That was a good release by him. Just rimmed out. In and out. Let's see if he gets better luck on the second one. Trying to put his team up six. Another nice release, but short. Now, breathing still. Can they get what they need? They can. They get a three. He hasn't made one all game. He does now. Anthony Lloyd with a huge one. And they called a foul. Oh, my goodness. He dribbled it off his foot out of bounds. Oh, boy. That looked like it was dribbled off of. Oh, my goodness. That was dribbled off of Kiefer Jerome's foot. Should be John Caldwell ball. But it's not. Now, they're going to have to get to LePage and foul him. They don't. They're going to have to get to somebody and foul him. They do. And number five, that is on Purley, and that's going to be his fifth. That's a big loss for John Caldwell for these last 10 seconds and for any potential overtime. They're going to use their 30 seconds, but boy, oh boy, look to me like, I'd love to go back and watch this because I'd love to be, I don't mind being proven wrong, but it looked to me fast speed, like Kiefer Jerome just dribbled that ball out of bounds and maybe anticipating a foul. The whistle was blown a little bit early, but that's how it looked to me. Then they decided that the ball had been kicked out of bounds by John Caldwell, which is not how it looked to me from my position. I'll be eager to go back and look at this after. But now, Dalhousie again. Another chance to salt this away at the line. Two free throws would make this a two-possession game. And with 10 seconds left, that would mean everything, you would think. The first one down and pure from a great 10 kid. In a big spot, giving his team a three-point lead. Can he make the second? Put this game out of reach. He does. Now, barring something crazy, Dalhousie's going to take this banner. But if you're a John Caldwell fan, here's your hope. I've got to keep the fans involved. I've got to think of the sponsors. Got to keep the fans watching. Can't lose any eyes on this game. Come on, announcer. Be better than that. No, if you're a John Caldwell fan, you get a quick hoop here, and you don't necessarily, you can't think about three. You got to think of the quickest way to get the ball through the hoop as possible and get a foul committed to get them back at the line. So this is a tall order with 10 seconds left, but it's definitely possible. So if you're John Caldwell, I would imagine get the ball in the hands of Cody Michaud or Caleb Bouillia here. Try to somehow get them going downhill towards the hoop. Maybe get a foul call. Well, foul call doesn't do you any good unless you're going to the line. Only two fouls on Dalhousie in this quarter, so they can be super aggressive on this out of bounds. Going for steals even. You don't want to sell yourself out, give yourself up a layup, a quick one to John Caldwell, but you can certainly be super aggressive. Play aggressive, go for that ball. Worst case scenario, you're committing a foul and you go, and they have to check the ball back out again. That might even be a tool used by Dalhousie in this situation to make them take the ball out again. It's going to go all the way around to Lloyd. He just made one, but no, blocked, and it's going to go out of bounds. No, it's picked up, and the Dalhousie Condors are 0.2 seconds away from their first NBIAA single-A championship in at least a dozen years. So excitement from the Dalhousie fans. They all want to storm the court. And the players, they got to wait 0.2 more on the line for them, number 11, Jaden Mullally. And it's fitting. He's been terrific in the second half. His foul shooting hasn't been his strength. He's missed a few at the line here. But his defense has been so key, as has everyone for Dalhousie. And he knocks one through. Love to see that. Pushes it out to a five-point game. Get ready to celebrate, Dalhousie. He misses the second, the ball comes back to him, and it doesn't matter. Storm the floor, Condors. It's your first championship in a long while, and it's worth the wait if you're a Condor fan. 51-46, Dalhousie takes down the John Caldwell Golden Knights in the single-A boys final here at TD Station. And the Dalhousie fans are up and rowdy. Boy, that was an unbelievable final, fans. Back and forth, the coaching adjustments, the player adjustments, and this is what you want to see out of a final after 2 years of tough stuff for these kids. Super competitive, super well played in those last three quarters, and both teams can hold their head high that they played well, and you'll see plenty of these young and talented John Caldwell Golden Knights in years to come. But for this year, it belongs to the Dalhousie Condors, your single-A champs on the boys' side, NBIAA 21-22. So enjoy the post-game celebration, fans. Enjoy the possession of the banner. I'm Dave Tingley. I'm happy you joined us. I had a great time. Join us again at 3:30 for the AAA girls' final. A couple of juggernaut squads there, the two-loss Moncton High Purple Knights and the undefeated FHS Black Cats, 3:30 on this channel. Come back and find us. I'm Dave Tingley. Thanks for joining us. We'll talk to you in a bit. Enjoy the post-game, fans. Thank you.
All right, folks, we're ready to get ready to present our post-game awards. First of all, for the runner-up medals, the Final 12 committee would call upon hostess Shannon Frazier and hostess Cindy Floyd to present the awards. And would the coach of John Caldwell please come forward, Michelle Beaulieu, to help hand out the medals. Please come forward when your name is called. Number two, Cody Michaud. Number three, Cohen Pietien. Number four, Anthony Lloyd. Number five, Caden Purley. Number six, he's a graduating senior, Colin Sullivan. Number seven, Stern Cillian. Number eight, Alex Gillette Sear. Number nine, Isaac Anderson. Number 23, he's a graduating senior, Caleb Beaulieu. Number 24, Owen Kinney. Number 25, Evan Dubay Nickerson. Number 33, he's also a graduating senior, Louis-Henri Verity. And number 44, Caden Brayall. Team manager, Melissa Moreau-Purley. The assistant coach, Joey Brayall. And the head coach, Michelle Beaulieu. And now would the captains of John Caldwell please come forward to receive the NBIAA runner-up plaque. And this time, the committee would call upon Mr. Dave Shields to please come forward and present the game ball to head coach Rodney Savoy. And Rodney, you can hang around here. We're going to present the medals to the champions from Dalhousie. Please come forward when your name is called. We have a graduating senior, number one, Tyler Winchester. Number four, Caleb Savoy. Number five, can't be here, his name is Chad Beakey. Number six, a graduating senior, Sebastian Noel. Number seven, Connor Mullally. Number eight, Gio Hernandez. Number 10, Hunter Lepage. Number 11, Jaden Mullally. Also in sick bay, we have number 12, Ashton Bullen. Graduating senior, number 13, Kiefer Jerome. Number 14, Brandon Millay. And number 15, Armani Hernandez. And your head coach, Mr. Rodney Savoy. And now we would please ask Mr. Dan Patterson, to present the Player of the Game Award to the runner-up team. And the Player of the Game from John Caldwell is number 13, Kiefer Jones. Oh, got that backwards. Number 23, Caleb Beaulieu. We have a typo. And now Dave Shields will present the Player of the Game from the champions. And that would be number 13, Kiefer Jerome. And one little item left to take care of. We'll call upon Allison Ouellette to please come forward. And she is the executive director of the NBIAA. And we'd ask the captains, please, from Dalhousie to come forward and receive the championship banner. On behalf of the committee, we'd like to congratulate both teams for making it here to TD Station. A lot of hard work, so congratulations to both teams. Pictures can be taken at the west end of TD Station. We ask that you please not come onto the floor while the guys are cutting down the nets. Thank you for supporting high school basketball. We wish you a safe trip home. Thank you.